Hello there! Welcome to my AI training lab. Previously, we trained a boxing AI. We taught that humanoid to run faster than Usain Bolt. Yes, the one in black pants. And this little guy, our bipedal robot, we trained it to do parkour. But today, ladies and gentlemen, we have something a little different. You are currently watching a worm's body controlled by a neural network. The movement is indeed erratic, but do you know what else is erratic? A newborn baby. That's right, this AI is at step zero, aka 0 hours of training. Over time, the AI gathers information about its environment and improves, just like an infant. But this is no ordinary infant. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for an open brain surgery. This is a neural network, a biomimicry of the most complex object in the whole universe, the human brain. In this video, we progressively train the worm using larger neural networks, starting with the brain of a single-celled organism like paramecium, all the way to the brain of a mouse. To train a neural network, we give it inputs, which it then processes into outputs. The middle section is where the processing happens. The larger it is, the higher the IQ of the AI. We begin by giving our AI basic self-awareness. This can be achieved by extracting the position, rotation, and velocity of each body segment, arranging it into a vector and feeding into the neural network. This gives the AI body awareness, a feature humans are born with. The worm's body is equipped with 7 rotatable joints, all controlled by the neural network. These will help the worm during locomotion. Since we are using a reinforcement learning algorithm, we need to define a reward function. Every frame, we record the velocity of the worm's body. This velocity is then compared with the goal velocity. The closer it is, the higher the reward. This forces the AI to move, encouraging locomotion. We are not explicitly telling the worm to move its body segments or wiggle its tail a certain way. We are just providing high-level feedback based on velocity. The resulting movement style is an emergent behavior and is what makes reinforcement learning fun. The AI will also receive a small reward for collecting these cubes. Ladies and gentlemen, as promised before, we will start with the smallest neural network. It's time to find out what happens when we give a large creature a very, very small brain. The movement of our AI is indeed questionable. It's tempting to blame the physics, but I assure you that Unity has an excellent engine with gravity, friction, and fluid resistance as well, all enabled in this simulation. The problem lies elsewhere. You see, our worm generates 124 observations and 21 actions. Cramping all of that into a 64x2 network is a recipe for disaster. Cherry on top, the AI had a decision transition period of 1, meaning insanely fast reaction times. That and the absence of joint dampening resulted in extremely erratic movement. So, going forward, we will enable joint dampening. The reaction time will be increased to 5 and the network size will be upgraded from 64x2 to 128x3. This is a significant improvement and gives the worm more computational power. You know how they say, walk before you worm? So we will now take a step-by-step approach and use a smaller prototype. Once it trains successfully, we will then change back to the larger worm. Ladies and gentlemen, let's see what our AI learns this time. Our training was a success. The prototype now exhibits locomotion similar to real-life worms. Speaking of learning and improvement, as someone who is fascinated by AI, I have been eager to dive deeper into AI art generation. Skillshare has been the perfect community to help me level up these skills. It is the largest online learning community for creatives, offering thousands of classes led by industry experts. Whether you're into film, illustration, design, or even AI and innovation, Skillshare has something for everyone. I have been taking this amazing class on AI art generation, taught by a professional photographer with 10 years of experience in the art world. What I love about this class is that it teaches you how to set up stable diffusion on your own PC. It's completely free, runs locally and privately, and gives you total creative freedom without censorship, something you can't get with platforms like Midjourney. But that's just one of the many classes available. Skillshare offers learning paths, which are curated, sequential class collections designed to help you master specific skills or competencies. The best part? The first 500 people to use my link in the description will receive a 1-month free trial of Skillshare. Get started today and unlock your creative potential. Thanks to Skillshare for sponsoring this video. Congratulations, you made it to the end. It is now time to fulfill the worm's destiny and use the largest neural network. This is Cozmouz, signing out.
6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Electric. 7, 8.